Jimmy, first of all, Happy New Year. How was Christmas and the New Year?
Yeah, it was good. It was nice to be at home, spend it with the family, and obviously going away for a decent period of time now, so it was nice to get that sort of time at home and enjoy it while we can.
Last time we saw you was at the Alexandra Palace for your darts match with Cookie. How'd you look back at that?
Thanks for bringing that up. Yeah, I'm still pretty devastated, to be honest. Yeah, it was good fun though. I mean, it was a great night, and just disappointed I couldn't get the win, because it means years of bragging rights for Cook, unfortunately.
Looking ahead to the World Cup, you're fourth. What does it mean to play in the World Cup for England?
Well, I mean, it's an amazing experience. I think for me, looking back, my first World Cup in 2003 was a fantastic experience in South Africa. Something that I'll never forget, and it was quite early in my career, and it does mean a huge amount, and particularly you know, you're representing your country and you've got a chance of winning a major trophy, and that's something that we're all really excited about, you know, having the chance to do.
What about that first World Cup, what memories do you have?
Well, for me it was a really successful one on a personal level. Unfortunately, from a team's point of view, it wasn't great. You know, looking back, there's a lot of issues around it. We didn't go to Zimbabwe for a number of reasons, and that meant that we went out of the competition earlier than we would have liked. So, yeah, I mean, having a taste of World Cup cricket so early in my career was something that you know, I'd dreamed about as a kid, and it was every bit as good as what I thought it would be. So it's something that when the World Cup does come around, it really excites me.
As someone who's played in three World Cups, obviously this will be your fourth. What's your advice to the guys who will be playing in their first World Cup?
I think just to enjoy it. The beauty of it is at the minute that, you know, there's not a huge amount of expectation on us because our one day form's not been great recently. So I think, you know, the pressure's not on us in that respect. So the guys can go out there and just enjoy it. It's a great experience. It's a huge spectacle. You get to play against pretty much all the, you know, all the nations out there, that some fantastic teams that are out there, and also teams that have qualified that are very dangerous, but you get to play against teams that you've maybe not played before, which is great. So just try and soak up as much of it as possible and really enjoy it.
You mentioned about the expectation from the public maybe isn't particularly high, but there must be a level of optimism within the team that we can do well.
Of course, we've got to go out there thinking we can win the World Cup, otherwise there's no point turning up. We honestly think we've got a good chance. We think we've got we know we've got a huge amount of talent in our team, and we can certainly challenge the best teams around. So I think once we get to the World Cup, it's all about trying to get some momentum going. If you can get on a run, then you never know. You get to the quarterfinals, then you're just two good performances away from getting in a final. So that's the way we're looking at it, and hopefully we can surprise a few people.